is the Onion News Network.
Free. That is your toll-free call-in line. It's King Mark the First with you.
And Johnson.
855-450-3733. Or you can use Skype. Toll-free number is, excuse me, the username on Skype is lrn.fm. Well, we had a lot of interaction on our Facebook page today because of a post I put up. Which, you know, I found someplace, I guess Liberty Memes. And it's Bernie Sanders, who, of politicians, I find to be less distasteful than most. He is...
Really?
Yeah, he's very much a socialist.
Yeah, but I find him to be way more distasteful than most for probably the same reasons.
He claims it. That's what I find to be, you know, but it's something that I can live with, right? Like, he doesn't lie about what he believes. Many politicians stick their finger in the air and, you know, they compromise their principles. They don't, you know, they'll lie to get what they want, to get into office. I mean, it's just, you know, largely distasteful. Bernie Sanders has found a way to be a socialist, claim to be a socialist, and get elected. And... okay, I like him better than, say, Hillary Clinton.
Wouldn't the picture that you posted indicate very clearly that he, in fact, does lie?
What do you mean?
Or at least that he's extremely dishonest?
I don't think he's extremely dishonest. I don't think people see their own foibles. Let me explain it. It's a image of him saying, everyone deserves a living wage of at least $15 an hour. And that's why I pay my campaign staff $12 an hour. And it's true. I looked it up. The internships for Bernie Sanders are $12 an hour. Now, some may say an internship doesn't need to be, you know, I mean, that's not a full-time job. That's not supposed to be a living wage. But wait a second. Do you know of any internships that pay less? Less being something besides zero. Less than the current minimum wage? Because basically... the current minimum wage laws, and it doesn't matter whether it's an internship or what it is, make it so that you either have to work for nothing as an intern mm-hmm. or minimum wage, which I think is like $7 an hour or whatever.
Right.
And, you know, I mean, if you take five silver quarters from 1965 and you do the melt value of them, you're going to find something close to $15 an hour. Precious metals are down a little bit, but it's still a heck of a lot more than $7 as far as the melt value of these quarters. So you can see that there's more of a problem with the money than there is with wages and that sort of thing. I mean, if you look at it, it's a problem with devalued currency, not a problem with the wages keeping up with the things on time. But I mean, and I think that $12 an hour is really good pay, frankly, for an intern.
Yeah.
Maybe that's what he has to pay. I don't know. Maybe he wants to give extra because he's a good guy. I don't know the answer to that. I don't know what other politicians pay for their internships, but...
he should probably be paying $15 an hour.
Why?
Because if he's lobbying for a $15 an hour minimum wage,
he probably doesn't even know.
Wage of $15 an hour.
Like, he doesn't look at what
he's... if he doesn't know what he is paying people... he is a terrible person.
Well, okay.
Like, I'm sorry. Especially if he's a politician.
You're pointing out his hypocrisy, and this is hypocritical. That's the whole point of the meme.
Like, he's supposed to be this down-to-earth people guy, right? He's a man of the people. Well, if he doesn't know how much he's paying his campaign staffers, then there's either two things going on. Either he's dishonest and a despicable lying liar, typical politician who's lobbying for a $15 minimum wage and using that to forward his political career while paying his own campaign staff $12 an hour, being a complete hypocritical lying scumbag, or He's a hypocritical person who claims to be a man of the people who doesn't even know what his own employees are being paid because he isn't really a man of the people. He doesn't care, and he doesn't even pay attention. He probably doesn't even know any of the names of his campaign staffers if he doesn't know what they're being paid. Okay. That kind of thing.
I'm not willing to go as far as you're going on this. What I see is a socialist campaign that cannot avoid the realities of the free market. The reality of the free market is his interns
all socialist campaigns.
Yes, absolutely. That's really the point here, is that Bernie Sanders is an honest socialist, as best of an honest socialist as you're going to find. And, you know, the fact is that human beings...
Which makes him basically the greatest threat to freedom.
No, he's not. Yeah. I'm sorry, a 70-year-old Jewish man is not going to win the presidency. He is a sideshow. He's a bear on a unicycle juggling bowling balls, okay? He has no relevancy other than the fact that he frames the issue. Like this.
Yeah,
is,
you think Hillary's the main attraction for the Democratic Party? Is that, what you're thinking?
I would love to be wrong, but I will further give you this. Okay, so Bernie Sanders gets the socialist vote. He really gets people excited.
Which is basically most of the Democratic Party at this point, in my mind, anyway.
Who is going to come out and vote for Bernie Sanders that wasn't going to come out and vote for Hillary Clinton?
Anyone who really doesn't think that a woman is going to be able to do a better job in the presidency than a man would, which is probably a large number of people.
The sexist leftists?
Yeah.
You're talking about the sexist leftists?
Oh, yeah. Okay. I think that there are a massive number of racists, sexists, and just general jerks in the left side of the movement, and they're just not honest about it.
I think you would have said the same thing about Barack Obama, that he wouldn't have had a shot either because he's black.
Actually, no. I thought Barack Obama absolutely was going to win.
Okay.
So it's like Barack Obama seemed like a shoo-in. It's a totally different type of – a totally different situation.
Hillary Clinton has executive experience being the Secretary of State.
Sure.
And Bernie Sanders has the experience of getting elected as a leftist in Vermont.
I just don't think that it necessarily matters. I think that
the left
side of politics, they're the collectivists, man. Collectivist philosophies ring true with these people.
The left and the right have no neither one has a monopoly on collectivism.
Sure, no, I don't absolutely agree with you there.
Okay, I disagree. I think that the leftist will vote for a woman simply because she is a woman. That there will be a certain amount of people that will vote, a certain amount of Republican women that will choose to vote for Hillary simply because she has two X chromosomes.
I think that's a distinct possibility, absolutely.
So I'm of the opinion that Hillary Clinton is more electable than Bernie Sanders.
But I also think...
She's also younger, she's got more experience, and she's a woman.
You're discounting...
Men, by the way, get more votes in elections than men do.
Yeah, you're discounting the fact that there's also a large number of people, even amongst women, who will not vote for her because they think that a man should run the country.
I'm telling you,
I think that the numbers
disagree with you.
Really?
The numbers disagree with you. A woman will get about 3% more at the polls, all things being equal, than a man. And this is just, I mean, there have been lots of women in campaigns, and so far, what you say...
Good. Okay, good. Yeah. Then I'm glad to be wrong about that.
I don't know that you're wrong. I mean, we could be talking about Hillary Clinton specifically.
Sure.
She's had a lot of bad press.
Sure.
And
she's awful.
She has terrible, terrible things, some skeletons in the closet.
No more video games.
But I think it's awesome. That is not why people are not going to vote for her, Johnson.
Well, I'm just saying that's one issue of which she's ridiculous on.
Okay, well, there's people that believe she was involved in the death of Vince Foster and a bunch of other dead people. I mean, like, she was in charge. She's a pro-war candidate.
I specifically went for the petty one because it's so ridiculous.
Right.
I mean,
nobody.
She's got many, many, many deep-seated issues upon which there are definitely problems with Hillary.
The percentage of people that will not vote for Hillary Clinton because of her stance on video games two
very
decades
small.
Ago
exactly.
is very, very,
sure.
very small.
Just like it's the stance of which people ignore. See, the issues that I care about, people ignore, like, with... my brain is not
Sanders?
Working properly. No, our current vice president.
Joe Biden.
And the RAVE Act.
Yes.
Nobody paid attention to that he was responsible for basically no loud music parties that play electronic music because they have drugs all over them.
What do you think? Who's the most likely candidate and who's the one most likely to win on the Democratic side? I guess we're talking about that. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live, or LRN.FM on Skype.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the Free State, and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about anything. We, for whatever reason, are talking about Hillary Clinton versus Bernie Sanders and who's more likely to win and why and whatever. Bernie Sanders has really caught fire recently, and he's he's very, very popular right now. And these things happen at the beginnings of elections. Another thing that's very popular right now, bitcoins. I just saw an article where there's lots of businesses in Argentina which are switching over in order to avoid inflation, which of course one of the problems that Greece is sort of looking at. So if the folks in Greece would have switched, businesses would have been taking Bitcoin in Greece, then they would have been a lot better off. And what you can do now is you can get between 15 and 25% off your purchases at Amazon simply by going to purse.freetalklive.com. If you use Bitcoin. Now, that's the trick with Purse, is that because Bitcoin is an international currency, you're able to do business with people around the world. Now, you're going to have to wait an extra day or so in your order, but I find that most of the purchases I make off of Amazon, I can wait. And we're making a lot more at my house now that we can get 25% off of pretty much everything we buy.
So let me ask you a question about Purse. I'm an Amazon Prime member.
Yep.
So one thing that I've heard about Purse that makes it not as great, and I want it to be great, so I'm wondering if there's a way to negotiate this from somebody who's actually done this. I've heard you have to pay shipping. You have to pay the shipping fees. Even though you're an Amazon Prime member, if you're trying to buy something off of Amazon, you know, through Purse, that whoever is you're buying from, you know, is going to charge you the shipping fee. So it's not necessarily 20% off or something.
Not entirely sure how it works. Somebody has asked that question to me, and I've actually been waiting for Ian, who does all the purchases for his household, because he's it. Mm-hmm. He is his household. However, the purchasing director at our house is my wife.
Right.
She decides, what gets purchased, when it gets purchased, and if it gets purchased. So I know that she's using Purse, so therefore she believes it's still a savings.
Yeah, I mean, if it's 20% off, I mean, if you're buying items that are expensive enough, that's going to exceed the shipping amount for sure. Yep. I mean, it seems like that's still a no-brainer.
So Purse.freetalklive.com. All you have to do is go there, sign up, and get some Bitcoin. If you want to get Bitcoin, get it from expresscoin.com. I'll tell you how to do that here shortly.
And it doesn't stop at 20% off, too. From what I've heard, you can actually go up to 50% off.
Ian's got it as high as 29. You can put 50% up there as far as what you want to save, but you have to get somebody to agree to sell to you at that point. And it's not that complicated. Go watch the video at purse.freetalklive.com. And basically, 15 to 25% off is what you need to know.
I wonder if you're going to be more likely to get a higher discount on a... Well, this is hypothetical. I'm just going to put it out there anyway. But I wonder if you're going to be more likely to get a high discount on a lower-priced item or a higher-priced item.
I don't know. I would be very interested in finding that information out myself. Let's go to Trey calling in from Portland, Oregon. Trey, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hey, gentlemen. So, I think that Sanders has a...
We're talking about decent... Bernie Sanders and Hillary Clinton. Go ahead.
Right. I think that Bernie Sanders has a decent chance of beating Hillary, so long as he can, withstand her attacks, and so long as he can stay true to his traditional message. I mean, that he's kind of always had. You know, he hasn't really changed much from
things he's
said throughout the years. Yeah, and but I think the other reason he's so popular and is that, just like Donald Trump of all people, he speaks his mind and he doesn't apologize, which is why, you know, Trump is so popular with these the conservative folk at the moment. Now, I do think that if Hillary were the one to win the Democratic nomination, that she will be the next, fascist in chief, if you will. Donald Trump were the one to win the Republican, nomination, because I think that would make Hillary a surefire bet for president. That if it looks like it's going to be that, unless something changes, that if Trump were to become the Republican nominee.
If Trump becomes the Republican's nominee, I will eat this crown I am wearing on my head. I mean, or at least part of it. It seems like a lot to eat. I wouldn't do it all in one sitting. Anyway, this is it. But my God, I can't even imagine this happening. Really, this is a flavor. I believe this is a flavor of the week kind of situation. We saw in 2011, they went through what Tim Pawlenty, I believe was his name. They went through the crazy Christian lady, Michelle Bachmann. They had 999 Herman Cain. I can't remember who else they rolled through, but pretty much everybody but Ron Paul got their turn as the big the one that was the front runner, and they went with the establishment candidate.
I don't know. Jeb Bush seems like one of the dumbest options that this country could pick, so that's probably the one that we'll get.
Yeah. Well, and did you see the interview with Seth Meyer and Rachel Maddow from last night? I think it was, and Seth Meyer made a good point that everybody, you know, every politician trips up somehow with, you know, in their debates and with what they say. And everybody's waiting for Trump to do that, but he like does it brazenly anyway. He just says what's on his mind, and so it's not like he's gonna trip up because people are loving that he just speaks what's on his mind, and that's such a ridiculous thing that people are admiring the things that he says.
Yeah, I think that once the reality of that this guy might actually be president strikes the average voter, they're going to do away with that that notion. Trump is, first he's a real estate mogul, which means that he's comfortable with carrying a tremendous amount of debt. And secondly, he's a television guy, which means that he understands that what you need to do is not motivate 50% of the people enough to vote for you, but 5% of the people enough to watch you for a half an hour, which is a much bigger commitment. And what he's doing, it seems to me, is running for his next show or his next season.
You know, the funny thing is the only reason that I could even mentally entertain Donald Trump being president for even a mere moment would be just to hear him like at his presidential inauguration be like, Barack Obama, you're fired.
I'm for it.
Yeah. And can I just say one more thing and I'll let you go, is that I hadn't planned, I'm a libertarian myself, I had not planned on voting in this next election, and the reason I decided that I'm going to, and tell me if this is a bad idea. I don't know, but it just appeals to me because, you know, I like the idea of upsetting the established political, you know, establishment, and that I might vote for Sanders just because at that level, I don't think good people generally become president. But I was thinking just because if he won the Democratic nomination, then it would really upset the you know what's been established now for forever. I mean,
let's usher in socialism. Wonderful idea.
He's also an anti-war candidate, by the way. He voted against all of those.
Whoop-de-doo.
Well, look, I mean, you know,
right.
Have a police state, not a military industrial complex.
Well, I'm not sure that you're necessarily going to get a police state from Bernie Sanders, but I would say that what I recommended to people Democrats back in 2012 was to go ahead and vote for Ron Paul in the primary because, you know, they would take any Democrat. So, fine. I'm fine with you voting for Sanders. It's not like it's mathematically going to make any difference. Anything's going to change. Appreciate the call, Trey. 855-450-3733. Your thoughts. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Affordable health insurance was the promise of Obamacare, but for many, the government mandate caused more problems than it solved. And I want to tell you about a truly affordable alternative, Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare bypasses doctor and hospital panels, giving you the freedom to choose. 100% coverage up to $1 million per year per occurrence, includes dental, vision, pharmacy, and holistic care. Call 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993 today.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
A meme is not easy to define.
What is it?
But you know it when you see it.
Amazing.
Don'tTreadOnMeme.com proves that.
I feel so enlightened.
Don't Tread on Meme, M-E-M-E, helping you give the finger to our monetary system of deception by providing you with silver dime trading cards. Unlike today's dollar, they have value, and they look neat too.
Oh, would you look at those? Aren't those just swell?
Don'tTreadOnMeme.com. While you're browsing their numerous silver dime card designs, take time to download the easy-to-use Silver Calculator app. This simple piece of technology lets you know instantly, whether using iPhone or Android, just how much your silver coin is worth. Find out all the details at Don'tTreadOnMeme.com. Now accepting Bitcoin. Don't Tread on Meme, your path to a voluntary society with honest money. Don'tTreadOnMeme.com, serving you faster than the Fed prints money.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. That's the last four digits spell out the word free for those of you who don't know. My name is King Mark the First.
And I am Johnson.
And you
with
can
get... no title because I don't believe in any of that nonsense.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I look, you know, after the Caitlyn Jenner situation and the Rachel Donachel gal who is self-identifying as
Dolezal.
Black, whatever it is, Dolezal, self-identifying as black, I realized that I self-identify as your king. And by your king, I mean everybody's king. I am the intergalactic ruler of all I survey because that's what I, you know, that's what I self-identify as. I believe that. In my heart, I truly believe that I am smarter than you and more capable of giving, of running your life in the sense that, you know, like I can give you advice, better advice. Now, I'm not actually going to run your life because, you know, I don't care that much about you. You know, yeah, you know, you can run your life the way you want, but, you know, I know better how you should do it. And that's what I believe in my heart. So I should express who I am in the world. And that's what my belief is.
Are you also of Cornwall?
I am. I like Cornish flag, if that's what you're asking.
Well, the first King Mark was Mark of Cornwall.
Oh, well, there you go. I've always had this sort of soft spot for the Cornish. So
well,
I don't know what to tell you. Interesting, their own tribe, like the Welsh and the Scottish and the you know the Angles, you know the Cornish are their own tribe.
Mm-hmm.
I want to tell you real quick how to get those Bitcoins. I told you about ExpressCoin.com. If you go to ExpressCoin.com, you can get Bitcoins, Litecoin, Dogecoin. They make it fast, safe, and easy. You can do it with a money or order or check. They're a licensed money services business. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, it's ExpressCoin.com. They've got an app for you if you want to do it on your smartphone. You can get up to $40 worth of your favorite cryptocurrency, no fee at all. You should be doing this every week. Frankly, get $39 worth of cryptocurrency every single week, and then you can buy it and get the discount through purse.freetalklive.com because you're probably spending that much a week on Amazon. And if you're not spending that much a week on Amazon, you can reallocate spending that you're doing elsewhere to Amazon because they basically have everything. It's expresscoin.com, and couple that with purse.freetalklive.com, and there's a big savings. So
can we digress momentarily, because I really... I'm looking at this Wikipedia entry about King Mark.
Yes.
And the story of King Mark. And it's just, I feel that reading this will make fun of you. And I will greatly take pleasure in that.
Go right ahead.
In the prose Tristan, Mark's character deteriorates from a sympathetic cuckold to a downright villain. He rapes his niece.
In case people don't know what a cuckold is, it is a man whose wife is cheating on him and he doesn't do anything about it.
Right. He rapes his niece and then murders her when she produces his son, Maragus. He murders his brother, Baldwin, as well. In earlier versions of the story, Tristan dies in Brittany, far away from Mark. But in the prose Tristan, Mark stabs Tristan while he plays a harp under a tree for Isolt. I think that's how my name's pronounced. Though this version of Mark's character was popular in other medieval works, including the Romance of Palamedes and Sir Thomas Malory's La Mort d'Arthur, which is the famous story of King Arthur.
Is this going to get funnier?
It's funny because I'm finding it funny because it's such a tragic story.
It is a tragic
story. It's a very tragic story. So you've chosen to name yourself after this absolute bastard.
I've got some news for you. When it comes to kings, they're all absolute bastards.
Pretty much.
See, I'm a different sort of king. Let's go to Charles calling in from West Virginia. Charles, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Good day, gentlemen.
Good day, Charles.
Hello, Mark.
Yes.
If Donald Trump should become president, would you eat that thing on his head?
Well, if you held for that joke, it was worth it. I hear that's really his hair, whatever the hell that is going on there.
Really? Comb over.
What the hell was it on before it was on him?
I don't know. Some kind of little dog. Somewhere in America, a little dog is missing.
I'm sitting here looking at my dog walk away, and it kind of resembles.
It looks like the tail on a golden retriever.
She's kind of little.
Charles, that was an excellent joke. Thanks for the call. 855-450-FREE.
There's a great T-shirt that's got a picture of Donald Trump, and his hair is combed over. It's like an American, like the hair turns into a bald eagle, right? Like the hair turns into a bald eagle on his head. And then the text at the bottom of the shirt says, "We shall overcome."
We shall overcome. That's hilarious. This is what I love about the internet. The world is a significantly funnier place with the internet. Because now, funny people like Charles have an outlet. Now, in this case, he called in on a radio show and got a joke out there. But the funny people have an outlet where their joke can be spread far and wide. Instead of coming to, a small cadre of comedians on television or, touring comedians or whatever, you're getting your jokes from all the people all over America. And the fact is, even the most boring people have a good joke now and then.
Right.
If they take the time to turn it into a meme or something on the internet, you can really have a grand old time. And so that's why I like it. Anyway.
And you can repurpose memes and stuff into completely local level private jokes as well.
That's true.
Which is fun to do as well. Just things amongst your friends.
We were talking about Bernie Sanders advocating for a $15 minimum wage and then paying his interns $12 an hour. And I've touched on this many times on the show, but if you haven't heard, look, I'm not begrudging people a living wage. I believe you should get paid whatever you're worth. And that's awesome. You should and now with the employment market getting back up to speed, people will start making better wages. But one of the things that a minimum wage does is it prevents a market from contracting. Actually, it doesn't prevent it. It attempts to prevent a market from contracting. So if for whatever reason there's a let's use pork chops, pork bellies. I mean, this is a commodity, right? They trade that in an exchange in Chicago. When there's more pork, the price of pork goes down. Around Thanksgiving time, when all these turkeys come on the market, that's when turkey costs the least. We can see when there's, you know, an abundance of something, the price goes down. That's supply and demand. And that law of economics works in the labor market, too. So when you have an economic downturn like we did in 2006, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, in that time frame, then the marketplace for labor needs to be able to contract. And by that, I mean the price of labor needs to go down. And if it doesn't, here's something that happens. For one, some businesses go out of business, absolutely. Some businesses will have to change pricing because of it. But another thing that happens is that older people will displace younger people in the marketplace. The minimum wage is not intended to be a living wage. That's why they don't call it the living wage. They call it the minimum wage. The minimum wage is intended to be an amount that young people get paid so that they can learn how to do work. I made $3.35 an hour working at 15 years old, and that's what I got paid. And I was living at home, and it was fine because you're not supposed to be running a household on minimum wage. If you're in that situation, I'm terribly sorry. I'd like to find out more about your life, which probably means that you had kids too early, too. Still, I mean, we're talking about a long line of mistakes, and that doesn't have anything to do with an employer. What an older person does in a contracted marketplace is that a business owner says, well, I've got a choice between a 15-year-old and a 25-year-old. I think the 25-year-old is probably going to be a better employee because they've had longer in the marketplace, and so I'm not going to hire the 15-year-old. So the 15-year-olds don't get hired. Now, I know you can rest assured that the white 15-year-olds will get jobs at some point or another. But you need to look at what the economic downturn did to young black men. It destroyed their ability to get a job. We have created, because of the minimum wage, to some extent, we've created, in the black community, it's going to be a generation, sadly, unless they can turn it around, a generation of freeloaders and criminals because they never got a job because of the stinking minimum wage. That's one of the problems here. 855-450-FREE to call me crazy. 855-450-3733. Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit BlockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618, BlockitPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can get archives of Free Talk Live going back for years and years and years for free at archives.freetalklive.com. The rest of the shows out there, they're going to charge you for the old shows. Nope, Free Talk Live, we don't do that. Archives.freetalklive.com. We've been talking about Bernie Sanders, his campaign, sort of advocating for a living wage, $15 an hour minimum wage, and paying $12 an hour. His chances against Hillary Clinton. Donald Trump has come up. And I guess it's, this is sort of some of the things that people want to talk about right now. Free Talk Live generally isn't a show about politicians. But, hey, if you want to talk about politicians, we'll talk about them. 855-450-FREE. Bernie Sanders really has been winning the war over as far as fundraising. This is one of the things that really matters when it comes to winning political campaigns, is how much money can you raise? And Sanders has been doing it like Ron Paul did it, like, a $10 bill at a time. A lot of people, his support is deep. And a lot of people support his sort of populist socialist message. And I get it. I think they should have the leader they want to have. But one of the problems that people don't get with socialism, these ideas, these leftist ideas that he's got, is that it drives folks away. You can look at it when it drives away the big earners.
Mm-hmm.
You can look at it around the world, places that have low tax rates.
You just gotta get enough low earners, the ones that can just give you small amounts of money, just but in like large amounts of those small donors.
Yeah, well, that's
you gotta give away a free phone.
Well, I, as your king, I promise to give away more free things than Bernie Sanders. You should vote for me.
That's
I'll give double the things.
I've heard of a similar argument from our friend with the free ponies.
No, Vermin Supreme.
That's right.
Yes, he said he'd give away double things too.
Well, he's promising a pony for
it's a free pony,
right?
And it's a lampoon of, how ludicrous it is, how silly the government can get as far as giving things away. But when it comes to a politician, they can offer you all the things. As long as it's not coming out of their pocket, they can offer you everything.
Right.
The government should give you a free pony. The government should give you, you know, free ice cream Fridays. There's all kinds of ludicrous things out there the government can, you know, the politician can claim the government should give you. And why wouldn't they do that? At some point or another, relatively quickly, people are going to figure out, hey, you know, I can win if I just promise more free stuff. You know, you've got to couch it in the terms that you deserve it. You deserve free ice cream on Friday. There are other people that have ice cream any day they want it. So why shouldn't you get free ice cream? We know you can't afford ice cream on Friday because you're reallocating your money towards cigarettes and alcohol or whatever it is. So you should have free ice cream. Well, that's ultimately what it comes down to. That's what this message is about. Yes, I think Bernie Sanders is a more honest individual than the vast majority of sort of politicians I see out there. That's his brand, right? Like he's got a more honest brand.
I'm just thinking, I'm sorry, just in my mind is just jumping to the, the government style of free ice cream. It's like, you can have free ice cream, any kind of free ice cream you want, as long as it's vanilla.
Right. And the ice cream stinks. It's awful.
It's sugar-free.
But this will be the ice cream people want.
It's the government health plan sugar-free ice cream.
It won't be sugar-free.
That also is for, you know, it doesn't have any actual milk in it because it's, you know, they have to also cater to the lactose intolerant people.
Well, look at, if you want to know what the ice cream will taste like, look at public school. That's what it'll taste like. It'll also be divided amongst neighborhoods. Some people get the better ice cream and some people get the worse ice cream because some animals are more equal than others. This is the ludicrous nonsense sort of behind free schooling. You really think that public school's free? No, it costs more than any other school out there. And that's the way it is with all government programs. Bernie Sanders isn't promising you free stuff. He's promising you the most expensive, most ineffective, poor quality stuff that you can possibly imagine.
And you won't have any other options.
Well, the things that won't be acceptable will become the things that are, you know, will become, everything will become mandatory that isn't forbidden.
Right.
That's how the state is. And I don't think that Bernie Sanders is some kind of, neo Hitler or something like that. I don't think he'll run sort of a fascist type government, but
I think you're out of your mind. I think that once people get power, that it changes them. And somebody who's already a socialist, who already thinks that they know what's best.
They're all socialists, Johnson.
Well, sure.
Every president we've had, Ronald Reagan was a socialist. He believed in forced redistribution of wealth from working class people to whatever it was that government programs he thought, the military or whatever, Star Wars, whatever the program was. He presided over a 60-something increase in the government.
Right.
He could have vetoed all that stuff, and he didn't. They're socialists. Anybody who believes in state ownership of the means of production, to my mind, is a socialist. Now, some people will say it's community ownership of the means of production, which, all right, if you want to run a commune, that's fine by me. I'm not going to give you a problem over it. I don't see why you're trying to reclaim the term socialist, because I can assure you Bernie Sanders believes it's state ownership of the means of production, and that's how taxes come about. Because if they tax you, if income tax is a tax on your labor, a tax on your labor is a tax on your body. They claim to own your body. And they claim to own your property. That's where they come, property taxes. Property taxes look remarkably like rent paid on an annual or biannual basis because they claim the means of production, and everything comes from human bodies and the land. And that's the end of the story. They're all socialists, from the first king that ever put on a crown to the most liberal of politicians that we have today. If Ron Paul doesn't advocate for, the government to essentially compete in every area, and I'm not entirely sure he doesn't, but if he didn't, then he would have been a socialist too. He certainly took the paycheck they gave, which I don't think there's anything wrong with. If they've got a system there and you're going to get in the system to work against the system, I don't see any particular problem with taking a paycheck to do it. But, Bernie Sanders is just a more overt socialist. So what do you think? What do you think his chances are against, if he becomes the nominee? Do you think he'll be a better candidate for the Democrats or a worse candidate against the Republican?
Oh, you mean as opposed to, say, Hillary or somebody else?
Yeah.
I don't know. I really don't know.
I'm of the opinion that Hillary is a superior candidate for the Democrats, that she can, you know, that she'll draw that female vote in, and that's powerful.
I don't know. For some reason, it's strange, but I feel like Bernie Sanders would actually draw in more young crazies.
It could. You could bring the young vote in.
And I think that a lot of the young left people, like if you're on the left and you're young, you know, they tend to be nuts, I think, in my it's just my opinion. All the people
sure,
I've
young
met,
people tend
nuts
to be more
and
leftist.
Uninformed,
yeah.
You know.
Well, young people tend to be more leftist. I mean, right. I think that that's been true for quite some
I guess
time.
I'm just coming from my experience, you know, going to Occupy Wall Street. I was at, you sure. know, I was at the,
those people will vote for Bernie Sanders.
Right. You know, and it's just, yeah.
Let's go to Tyrone calling in from Lawrenceville.
Tyrone. Oh, I hope he's challenging what you said at the end of the last segment.
Tyrone?
Yes, yes.
You're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Okay. You know, I've been listening to Free Talk Live for a while now. And when the topic of race comes up, I just really wish that you and the other hosts wouldn't talk about black people at all because, you know, at best, it's ignorant, and at worst, it's kind of disgusting because you really don't know what you're talking about.
No, I 100% agree with you, and I actually feel bad that I didn't. I meant to challenge Mark at the time and say, you know, that what he said at the end of the last segment, yeah, it came off, it left a bad taste in my mouth too. So that's why I said as soon as you, I don't know if you heard me when you were coming on the line, I said I hope that you're calling in to challenge Mark on that, and it sounds like you are, but. I agree what he said sounds ignorant, but I would like to hear, you know, rather than just saying don't talk about race, I'd like to hear you, you know, say, is he wrong? You know, and if so, do you have, you know, something that you can say about that that's, you know, that is.
We're going to have to find out what I'm wrong about because at this point, some people have tuned in and don't know what we're talking about.
Right.
So, Tyrone, can you reset us?
Can I do what?
Can you reset us? Can you tell us, you know, exactly what it was that I said that bothered you? And, well, anyway, we're going to talk about, you know, my flub up here. Tyrone's going to, if you could just hold the line for a minute, Tyrone, I'd like to talk to you about this more because, you know, this is it, right? This is Free Talk Live. People can call in with their opinions, and it's not like the hosts know everything or anything like that. So, Tyrone, hold the line if you would, please. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733, Free Talk Live.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit strategicshelters.com.
I'm a carbon fiber 29er full suspension mountain bike. My owner and I are attached to the hip, literally. Or we were, until the apartment got robbed while he was at his vinyasa yoga class, and the burglar used me to make his getaway. My owner's gonna be uber bummed when he realizes I'm gone. I guess he'll have to find another way to get his daily dose of adrenaline. Maybe he can take up urban beekeeping.
Your stuff can't protect itself. That's why the Geico Insurance Agency helps make it easy to switch and save on renter's insurance. Renter's insurance will cover personal property loss or damage as well as provide liability protection. Visit geico.com today.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, July 23rd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.82 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,099 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $279. Antiwar.com reports a suicide bomber detonated in a crowded marketplace in Afghanistan's northern Faryab province yesterday, killing at least 19 people and wounding 38 others. There's been no claim of responsibility thus far for the strike. The immediate suspicion was that it was a Taliban attack, as the Afghan government and Taliban forces have been fighting over control of the province, with both sides claiming some gains over the other in the past week. The Islamic State has also been active in some of northern Afghanistan as well. Provincial police say the attack targeted a group of soldiers guarding the market, but that the casualties also included a number of civilian bystanders. The fear is that the death toll will rise further because of the number of serious injuries. During this year's spring offensive, much of the Taliban's activity has been in the northern portion of the country, with efforts to secure territory that they did not even fully control before the 2001 U.S. invasion and occupation. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports Glacier National Park's most popular roadway was shut down and homes and lodging areas were evacuated as firefighters continue their efforts to contain fast-moving wildfires that were inching closer to populated areas. A section of Going to the Sun Road in Glacier National Park remained closed Wednesday between the park's St. Mary entrance and the east side and avalanche area on the west side in response to a 1,000-acre fire. The park operated 72-unit Rising Sun Motor Inn and cabins, and the nearby Rising Sun campground were evacuated. Chris Ross Miller, who was at the motel as firefighters were spraying down buildings, said, "It's smoky up here and nobody really knows how big the fire is." The fire was first reported around 3:45 p.m. Tuesday and quickly spread. Park rangers continued their search for backcountry hikers in the area. A temporary flight restriction was put into place over the area. Other wildfires as well spread quickly. Some were started by lightning strikes and others started by people. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports New York moved on Wednesday to raise the minimum wage for fast food workers to $15 an hour by the end of 2018 in New York City and by mid-2021 in the rest of the state. The New York Wage Board voted unanimously for the increase, which would cover some 180,000 workers statewide and affects fast food chains with 30 locations or more in the United States. The three-member board was formed at the behest of Governor Andrew Cuomo in May after the state legislature turned down his proposal for a minimum wage increase for most workers. Its decision does not need legislative approval, but requires approval by the state labor commissioner, which is expected. At a jubilant rally in New York City celebrating the vote, a beaming Cuomo said, "This is going to help hundreds of thousands of New Yorkers, but this is going to do something else, because when New York acts, the rest of the states follow." Last month, Los Angeles set its minimum wage to rise from $9 an hour to $15 per hour by 2020, affecting some 600,000 workers. Seattle and San Francisco have also increased minimum wage in recent years. The rise to $15 an hour marks a major step from New York's current minimum wage of $8.75 per hour. The increase would be phased in, taking effect by the end of 2018 in New York City and by July 2021 in the rest of the state. Business groups and other critics slammed the decision as discriminatory because it singled out one industry and legal challenges are expected. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
I play. good, kids. Now come and get your Ritalin.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. King Mark the First.
And Johnson.
And you can use the Skype lines. The username is lrn.fm. Let's go back to Tyrone. So Tyrone took umbrage with something I said regarding the minimum wage, which I believe was that the minimum wage affects young people, you know, it drives them out of the marketplace. And specifically, it harms, you know, people of color and blacks specifically, and black males. I was very specific. Tyrone sounds like a black male, so he's got more gravitas than I do on this subject, and he doesn't like the way I put it. Is that right, Tyrone?
Well, you know, it's not just what you said tonight, and actually my my statement was it was meant to be taken in general.
Okay.
The show was, you know, like I said, I've listened to Free Talk Live for a while now, some years now.
Yeah, I remember you calling in the past.
Okay. And I always cringe when the topic of race comes on, and especially black people, because, I mean, your views can only be myopic when it comes to us. That's why I wish you, if you don't have a black person on the phone, at least giving you some input or you feeding off of it, you know, it would probably be best not to make statements that you really can't back up. And it'll just sound really, like I said, it'll just really sound myopic to me.
Well, which statement can I back up? I mean, I know that we know that young black males were harmed by the recession far more than other groups, right?
I mean, that's the report.
Yeah, well, it is the report, and I mean that's all I can go off with. You're accusing me of being myopic, which I would concur. Everyone is myopic, and so the way that we deal with myopathy is to look at reports and those sorts of things to try to get things generally. I don't think that the recession harmed every black male or every person, but you know, there certainly are the numbers don't support that the recession was hardest on young black males.
Well, you know, and that may be the case, and that, I'm not here to argue that at all. Like I said, my statement was made in general, and I've been wanting to make this statement for a while now.
Yeah.
And tonight, I guess I was just pushed over the edge.
Yeah.
So I'm here to argue whether the recession affected black males worse than anybody else, because, you know, be that as it may, I don't know. But I think a lot of the problems that we have here in the States as far as what's happening to black people and people in general is we don't really know each other, and we tend to go off of what someone said or some government statistics. And I'm just, you know, I'm just living as a black male. I've been living this way for 48 years now.
You're pretty familiar with it.
See those. Yeah. I just don't see the rhetoric. I don't, you know, and like I said, I live this life, and I just don't see what people are talking about. I don't see us as violent, and I may be biased in my opinion. Of course I am, but you know, I just, to me, the biggest problem we have here is ignorance. We don't know each other, and we don't care to know each other. And you know, I think we're pretty happy with that until a hashtag comes up, and then we all jump on that, and then we, you know, go back into our corners after. You know, I think.
So
I'm just kind of really.
There's a lot about what you're saying that I tend to agree with, but what it does is it disempowers, right? So if we say that white people can't talk about the condition of black people, and if we say that black people can't talk about the condition of white people, then we drive a wedge between the groups, and we don't, we just say there's a bunch of no's involved. So, for instance, I'm reminded of the situation where the gal that plays Gwyneth Paltrow. I think she was out at some party with maybe P. Diddy or something like that. And
that would be Gwyneth Paltrow, by the way, that plays her in real life.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I was thinking of Tony Stark's romantic interest.
Penny.
Penny something. Whatever she is. She used the N-word in a tweet, but she used it in the sort of a colloquial sense, with the ending with an A, not with an E-R. And she was trying to be cool. And she got jumped all over for doing that. And it's like, and this Rachel Donazal, what's her name?
Dolezal.
She got in all kinds, a lot of people didn't like the fact that she didn't, she was self-identifying as black. And I'd like race to be less of a touchy subject, Tyrone.
Well, I think America is built on race, and it'll always be a touchy subject, especially coming from our corners, because that's where it's coming from, our corners. Like I said, we don't know each other.
Right.
And I don't think we really have any interest in knowing each other. I think we're good with news reports and whatever we read on the internet. I think we're satisfied with that until we have to face it for real. And, I hope it doesn't come to that, but...
Well,
I'm just really exhausted by the whole thing.
Oh, I get it, man. It is exhausting. The solution of the racial tension in this country is exhausting. I'm 100% with you on that. But I think that the best way to do it is simply integration. I'm of the opinion that if you look at sort of statistically, blacks that live in white neighborhoods do better as far as monetarily and those sorts of things than ones that live together in black neighborhoods. What's that?
But I terrorized the whole time that they're there. Forced integration will never work. I'm a
Not
firm
forced.
Believer in people should serve who they want. And that's what it is. It's forced. Because if you don't want to live next to me, then I certainly don't want to live next to you. I'm a firm believer people should serve whoever they want. They should live next to whoever they want. And if they don't want to live to somebody, that should also be their right. And it shouldn't be wrong to speak that. If I go into a store that doesn't want to serve me, I would rather know that and give someone my money that does not want me in the store.
Hell yeah.
I'd rather take my money to someone who's appreciated. I don't have a problem with people denying black people or whoever the right to serve them. I think it would be better if we knew that. We'd know who to stay away from.
I had my roommate was black for about a year. My friend Julian and I lived together, and I never saw one circumstance where anybody in the neighborhood gave him any kind of trouble or anybody thought anything. His race was never an issue, other than when I was watching, playing a video game together, and the video game had some sort of racial slurs in it, and I got very embarrassed. But he said that it just gave authenticity, and it water off a duck's back to him. But I never, nobody in the neighborhood said, "Why do you got a black guy living with you?" I don't know. I mean, sometimes I feel like the problem's perpetuated by people's preconceptions as opposed to actually, overt racism.
Well, one of the benefits of being white is you never have to think about race because your race is never an issue.
Often,
one of the very many disadvantages of being black is race is always forefront in our thinking. Always, you always have to consider it. No matter what you're doing, you always have to consider your race. And that may sound a little extreme, but it's the absolute case.
In what ways do you have to consider it? Because Julian worked as an insurance salesman for while he was living with me, and he would go to people's houses and talk to them about life insurance and that sort of thing. And one guy said, "Now Julian doesn't sound black," so the guy said, "And don't bring any black people with you." Now I don't know whether that's some kind of stupid joke or what it is, but I'm just going to assume that it's racism, right? I'm just going to say that's racism. I found it. Here it is, folks. And I guess I can see how race would be an issue, but how does it present itself that you always have to think about race? You're right. I don't have to think about race much.
Well, Most of it, like I said, I've been this way for 48 years. So most of the stuff, most of the racism that we face is so, it's just so slight that you just ignore it and you get used to it. And that's just a part of, that's just a part of your background. You know, it's just what you're, and like I said, you get used to it. So, you know, you know it's there, but, you know, you can't deal with every issue. So you just get used to things. And a lot of times people don't even know that they're being racist. It's just the way that they are.
Thanks for the call, Tyrone. I appreciate it. Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Identity theft is real. So real, it could be making you its next victim right now. At the gas pump, bank, or store where you shop with your credit card, bad guys with RFID scanners can peer into your wallet or purse from a short distance away, stealing information from your RFID-enabled credit or debit cards, passports, room keys, and ID cards without you even knowing it. Stop the bad guys now with an RFID-blocking wallet from ID Stronghold. ID Stronghold founded the entire RFID blocking industry over 10 years ago. Their stylish sleeves, clutch purses, and wallets are shielded throughout. The best you can buy at great pricing, as low as $14.99. Don't wait until your wallet needs replacing. Protect your identity now. Click idstronghold.com or call 1-800-610-2770. That's 1-800-610-2770. ID Stronghold, the original RFID wallet company.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
I love my Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With 4, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. Mymagicmud.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Here on this live edition of Free Talk Live, it's Mark with you.
And Johnson.
And you can call us on Skype. The username is lrn.fm. If you want to get, if you want to reach people with the ideas of liberty, you have the opportunity to do that every day. You can do it from the back of your car with libertystickers.com. You can reach thousands of people with a bumper sticker, tens of thousands, depending on how many people you're passing by in a given day. And, you know, people love to read them. You probably inched forward at a stoplight to read somebody's bumper stickers. I do it on a regular basis. I just want to know who I'm sitting behind. Well, you can check out the vast selection of witty, poignant, pithy, and downright bombastic liberty-oriented messages at libertystickers.com. It is libertystickers.com. Just spelled like liberty. So
I have an article here that I find interesting. It's a PDF in relation to what we were discussing in the last segment. Because one of the things I sort of, you know, I immediately had a kind of a reaction to when you were saying about the disparity in the unemployment amongst blacks in when you raise the minimum wage. It just, I mean, it's interesting because it's like, okay, well, then what are you, you know, is the implication that, you know, young black males are unskilled? Is it that they're unemployable? Or is it just race? Or is it just that their employers are racist? I mean, what's the implication?
Implication is that young people are unskilled.
Well, and not if it's based on race.
And that white people have more social networks from which to draw upon. And I think that those two things are sort of undeniable.
Is it social networks or social networks with employers? Because that seems to me to be ridiculous that, oh, white people are more social than black. Right. What? That doesn't make any sense.
More good, reliable social networks that are going to, you know, pick up the slack that the employment market didn't. One of the reasons that I'm employable today is that I started working at 12 years old. I went to work at a comic book store, and I worked there from the time I was 12 to the time I was 18. You know, I got minimum. I started getting paid in cash at 15. Made minimum wage for I don't know what period of time, but I shortly got a raise above that, and then you know at some point or another, it was never going to be the kind of job that was going to I was going to survive on, but it was fine for high school to give me spending money and that kind of thing.
Yep.
And
yeah, I started two jobs the moment I was on the verge of being 16. I started working when I was 15 illegally.
Right.
But I started working at Burger King and building computers.
And what the minimum wage does is it pushes young people out of the marketplace because it makes it they can't compete based on price. They can't compete based on working, you know, experience. They can't compete based on, you know, their sort of working skills. They've got nothing to compete with, so they're pushed out of the marketplace. This is true for all young people. And what my claim is that that you know, people in higher income brackets, which tend to be you know, whiter, more white people, they have the ability to, you know, sort of get their kids jobs.
Well, I don't want to read this, the full article here, but I'd like to read at least the first two paragraphs and see what you think here. So this article is from the Employment Policies Institute, or epionline.org.
Yep.
Unequal harm, racial disparities in the racial disparities in the employment consequences of the minimum wage increases. So it says, when the Great Recession's negative effect on the U.S. labor market was strongest, the national unemployment rate stood at 10.1%, a depth last seen June 1983. But the greatest amount of pain was felt by younger and more vulnerable workers, though not in equal amounts. For instance, the unemployment rate for 16 to 19-year-olds reached 27.1% at the recession's trough. For white teens, the figure was 25%. For black teens, it was close to 50%.
Right. Yeah. That was, you know, I didn't want to say 50% because I was remembering it, but that just sounds ridiculous to say that black teens were unemployment was at 50%. But that's, if, you know, if that's what they're saying, then I believe it fully.
Yeah. I mean, these are kind of older numbers. I mean, they're talking about, you know, 80s and stuff there. So, but it's still.
How does, and like, if we're talking about groups, Tyrone just called in and, you know, he didn't want us to talk about race because we sound, you know, myopic when we're doing it. And I don't disagree with him. I think it sounds terrible that Free Talk Live doesn't have any black hosts.
Sure.
Like, if we had a black guy sitting in here, like Tyrone, if Tyrone sat in here six nights a week or, you know, however many, it would add credence to racial issues. I get that that's how things are, but...
And it's unfortunate that that's the way it is. You know,
that's it.
I'm sorry. I really have this feeling, and, you know, frankly, I don't care. I mean, a lot of people... If I say that I'm bothered when someone says that I find it racist to say, oh, you can't talk about these issues because you're not black. You haven't experienced it. You don't have to think about race. That's your white privilege. I'm sorry. That to me sounds racist. And when
it's not racist, it's
it is, because what you're doing is you're judging what a person can say and do based on their race.
Okay.
You know, it's racist. I mean, I think ultimately the ultimate definition of race is saying that one race is superior to another. But in that case, when you're saying that one race can't do this and another race can, then you're saying that that one race is superior in their ability to act in a certain way.
Well, you would. It seems accurate, though, that, you know, perhaps black people might have a unique perspective.
Absolutely.
On black issues.
Sure, that, obviously. You
know, I can't provide.
Sure.
9 years in prison with a bunch of black guys isn't
going
to prepare
me with that. I'm not disagreeing with that. But when you say that white people can't speak on black issues at all, it's ridiculous.
I don't.
You know, and
he said, I wish that you didn't. Talk about it is what he said.
Right. And what I find that to be ridiculous, and I find it to be somewhat racist in and of itself, because what that is it's like people being bothered. It's like, oh, you can't talk about that. That's embarrassing. Or it's like a stereotype about, it's like that cringe feeling of, oh, it's that white person's talking about it, but they don't have a black person there to back them up. So therefore, everything that they say has to come off as racist.
Yeah. Well,
and that's ridiculous. It's a ridiculous thing that, you know, and
or dripping with white guilt, one of those
sure,
two things.
Right, one or the other. You're either dripping with white guilt and ridiculous in that way, or you sound racist and you're ridiculous in that way.
Oh, I haven't been looking at the thing. Harry apparently wants to chime in on this one. Let's go to the phones here. Harry calling in from, I think, Indy.
And don't get me wrong. I'm hoping that we're not going to have callers that call in and embarrass us right now.
Right. Harry, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi, it's Harry. What's up? Another black guy calling in.
Okay. We'll take your word for it, Harry.
No, it's okay. But Mark, you're pretty black. You probably got bad credit. Date a white woman, so yeah, you're probably black enough. But the thing is, I did want to say on the air is that do not be afraid to talk about race just because you don't have a black person in the room. I get pulled on all kinds of different podcasts because they want to talk about race and they just want another black guy in the room behind a microphone so they can talk about race.
Harry, I want to talk here. I want to hear a little bit more of what you've got to say. If you'll just hold the line here. 855-450-3733. This is it. The minefield of talk radio. Race. Talked about by, well, a room full of people who aren't very diverse. 855-450-FREE. I don't claim any race at all, but that's something.
Hey, you're 1/16th Jewish or whatever, right? So there you go. You're
less than that.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it. We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
I just heard the best sales pitch I've heard in a long time on an airplane. The flight attendant announced, If you paid more than $75 for your round-trip ticket, you overpaid. This is brilliant because everybody on the flight paid more, and I was struck by how all the road warriors stopped typing and reading and working and looked up. The announcement invited us to apply for the airline's credit card. And the sign-up bonus? Enough frequent flyer miles for a free round trip. Talk about turning lemons into lemonade. With some banks offering free credit cards, $75 is an outrage for an annual fee, but a bargain for airline tickets. For more tips on communicating more effectively, hit survivalspeech.com, where you can see how I got the CEO of another major airline to shower me with freebies. I'm Holland Cook.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
But we have the opportunity. No one has the opportunity.
Look, just hold on. Just because the slaves can pick the head slave doesn't mean that the slaves are free.
Oh, that's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. Look, if people actually got up and voted for things, there might actually be some change.
People do actually get up and vote for things, and a change always results in the same crap.
What are you going to do that's different by voting?
Two choices between crap sandwiches, man.
You're speaking out of both sides of your mouth. On the one hand, you're saying, oh, hardly anybody votes, so you can barely say this is a person of right. And then I say, well, gosh, if people get up and vote, maybe things will change.
Hold on, that was only one thing he brought up.
Here's what I mean.
When people do vote, it doesn't make any difference because of a number of reasons.
People never vote in numbers that could actually reflect what.
Why should I vote for any of these thugs? They're killers. They're murderers.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. 855-450-FREE. You can call in, talk about whatever you want to talk about. Somehow or another, we managed to get on the topic of race this evening. And, you know, always makes me uncomfortable. Johnson, how about you?
Sure.
Yeah. And I guess that's sort of part of the deal, right? Like, you know, I don't self-identify as white, but I imagine most people would look at me and say I'm white.
Here's what bothers me about the whole race conversation and racism in general. Is it's like racism is not something, you know, like I don't like being held accountable, you know, for something that I never would have invented in the first place. You know, like the whole idea of racism to me is ridiculous. I'm not a collectivist. I don't collectivize in that way.
But you can't deny the culture exists.
I don't care. You know, like, it's like I judge people based on the ideas in their brains. I'm obviously, I will admit, I am a bigot when it comes to religion. I don't like religion at all. That's an idea someone makes a choice to hold in their brain. And some people, I think it's more of a choice than others because I think that religion likes to indoctrinate children. But that's something that's a lot more of a personal choice. It's a belief. It's something that is not something that someone can't change about themselves. It's just the whole idea of collectivizing someone based on like physical features or how much
is, skin,
you know,
right?
Like the color of their skin or the shape of their eyes or the color of their hair or whether or not their hair is curly or not or any of that stuff. It's ridiculous. I can see, here's where I can go with racism or whatnot, or where I could see that maybe I as a person could have participated in, let's say racism didn't exist, but I make fun of people. You know, like I am, you know, my friends and people, we joke around, you know, like, you know, some I might be akin to say, hey, you big nose bastard, you know, something like that, you know, just to make fun of somebody because, you know, friends tend to do that, you know, snipe back and forth. But am I going to be like, oh, that person has a large nose, therefore they are inferior, you know, like and judge all people with big noses are therefore a class of people that need to be separated. And I'm not going to hire that person because they have, you know, it's like. Racism is such a ridiculous concept. I would never have come up with it, so I don't like being held accountable for what some other people do because there are racists in all races and of all colors and all types of people. Every culture has its racists.
Let's go back to Harry. Real quick, though, you can listen to Free Talk Live in a whole bunch of different ways. So whether it's live streams, great radio stations, satellite, webcam, listen lines, just go to listen.freetalklive.com to find out all the ways. Harry, you're back on Free Talk Live.
Hey. All right, Mark. So we did I've met you before at Porkfest. We were originally about 2 years ago at Porkfest, and one of the first discussions we actually talked about was about race.
Okay.
I don't know if you remember. I remember that.
I've been to every year, okay. And so no, I don't. Sorry, Harry.
It is totally okay. Like I said, like that's one of the cool things you've asked me about was like, how does Free Talk Live talk about race? And I like that you, Mark. I like you on the air because you have like that fiery passion. And the only timid thing you ever talk about, like when you kind of, I feel like you're kind of timid when you do talk about race.
Yep, I back off.
Bring that passion that you, yeah. I just like it if you just brought that same passion, bring to everything else that you brought to race. So, but and there's nothing that you said is wrong. Either.
Did we speak inside the media room?
Yes.
Okay, I think I do remember the conversation now. Yep, you're a big man.
Yes.
Yep. I recall now. So, yeah, I mean, well, like, but you do see, Harry, what happened when, you know, Tyrone calls in and he has what I think is it's a relatively good critique, which is, you know, hey, you guys are a bunch of white guys who are talking about race. You've got no social capital when you do that.
Yeah, I see. I see where it's a good gotcha on somebody that like in a whole room full of supposed white people. You know, that, you know, you don't have a black person there, so you can't talk about race, which that's utter crap, though. Especially when you're speaking the truth. A lot of the jobs that teenagers get are sometimes either server or, like, restaurant jobs. Those are most people's first jobs. And with a $15 minimum wage, those jobs are going to dry up inside, like, different black communities or at, like, the ethnic community. And the main people who are going to get jobs are going to be the teenagers of probably going to be white people at like country clubs who are going to just need part-time help during the summer or they're like on the weekends. And if their family's a part of that club or go to that catering facility, they're going to get those jobs.
Yeah. A former co-host here, used to work, she worked at Panera and she said that, you know, she had college students that were working there and that was their first job ever. I think this is a terrible thing for young people to not be able to, you know, not be able to know what it's like to have a job, how important it is to show up on time, to look good when you're doing it, how to talk to customers, you know, all the things that first job teaches you.
You can't talk about that, Mark, though, what you just shared, because what you were talking about, you said she and you're not a woman. So therefore, you can't talk about that experience because you just don't know. Why is that argument never made? See, that's the thing, that bothers me about this race conversation. Why is it okay? Why does anyone feel that it's okay to say, you can't talk because you're not that race? Why is it okay to say that, but nobody really says, oh, you can't talk about women because you're not a woman. You're not that gender. You can't even discuss about that. Is it really that hard to put yourself in someone else's shoes? Really? Like, I can't possibly understand what's going on with race because I just don't know, you know, like, it's like you think I'm never exposed to any black cultural stories or elements or that I can't learn about it through friends or other people or whatnot. I mean, I get that I haven't had certain experiences, but I read, you know, I watch media. I have some idea what's going on.
Harry?
Mm-hmm. Well, like the mind-bending thing is I still want to meet some more black people to tell me what defines a black person in America. What does it mean to be black in America? I know what it means to be hairy in America, and it's more of a, you know, the United States of America. Well, I know what that means.
Harry, I've got to say black, that I thought you were joshing us when you called in. I didn't think you sounded black enough, right? And then you just had you just told me about the conversation that we had, and I remembered, oh, yeah. How would anyone else know that? It's not like there was a bunch of people around that, you know, would have heard that conversation. It was you and me in the media room in Lincoln, New Hampshire, talking about this.
Yes. Yes. Yep. I get that on the phone a lot. I will talk to different clients on the phone, and they'll come to the facility, and they meet me, and they're first, like, you can tell in their eyes that there's like, oh, crap, this is a black man. I've been talking to a black man for like the last 6 months.
Yeah. It's got to be a bit of a surprise for them, you know? And these are just expectations. Yeah. And, you know, when people's expectations aren't met, generally it's just a moment of surprise and then everything's fine, right?
Correct. Correct.
Yep. Thanks for the call, Harry. I appreciate it.
Are you welcome?
Yep. Thanks. 855-450-3733. I do remember that that conversation clearly now. I wish that Free Talk Live was this sort of, this rainbow of, I wish we had far more female voices on the air. Johnson, I wish you were a black woman. That's what I wish. But the thing is
I'm very sorry.
I don't get that. I don't get to wish, you know, things on to people. That doesn't make a difference. I'm, you know, Free Talk Live, every one of our co-hosts is here because they want to be here, not because they're getting paid some tremendous amount of money. They're getting, you know, they're getting, in many cases, just little enough that they would show up, and you don't get paid for every show either. So, you know, that's it. If people, if we had a diverse rainbow of types of people that were trying to be on Free Talk Live, we might have a diverse rainbow, but we don't. We've got,
the show is also located in Keene, New Hampshire.
Well, but we advocate for the Free State Project, which is to get people to move to New Hampshire.
Sure, and that would be great. But as the reality stands as it is right now, Keene is, what, 1% black?
So it's not very large. I think it's less than the number you're actually giving. Also, when people of color move for the Free State Project, they tend not to move to Keene for whatever reason. Mm.
Well, Nashua and Manchester are much more urban areas. I mean, that's where people would gravitate to in general.
855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536. Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend, is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle, now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com, onesilversolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
Hi, I'm Derek J.
To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. The number's 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about whatever you want to talk about. King Mark the First here with you.
And Johnson.
Username lrn.fm on Skype. You call in that way. Usually sound a bit better. So it's username lrn.fm on Skype. That's lrn is in Liberty Radio Network .fm. So I've got an interest. I got today. You know, one of the hazards of my job is, you know, since I post, I read articles, I post them online. One of the things I don't always do is look for the date on a news article. And for whatever reason, some article passed in front of me, and I have a variety of ways that I see them, and I don't even remember them all. One of the ways is you go to freetalklive.com and you can post your article there. Maybe it was there. Maybe it was someplace else. But this article from 2012 about a girl getting spanked by a vice principal who was a different gender down in Texas. I don't have it in front of me here because it doesn't really matter. But I got on it. And I still think it's an interesting issue because I posted on the Free Talk Live's Facebook page, and one of the comments was something to the effect of, how is it that, you know, we don't beat prisoners in this country, but we can beat public school students or school students? Why is it that it's okay to hit kids, you know, regarding spanking, and it's not okay to hit prisoners? And I thought this was an interesting question. Really? Why is it? I don't know. They certainly have the prisoner equivalent of time out. You know, they got confinement where you can go in, and some people spend years and years in segregation.
I don't know. I think justice wouldn't be – I'm of the opinion that it wouldn't be a far cry from justice if the principal who spanks a student loses that hand.
Well, I don't see the point in taking their hand off. But in – this case, the kid was actually offered the opportunity to be spanked or have to go through another day of in-school suspension.
That's interesting.
I think it's a stupid punishment, in-school suspension. You know what we're going to do? We're going to take you out of your crappy government school class where you're learning something and have a high grade point average. In this case, supposedly she did. And we're going to put you in, well, the equivalent of, you know, prison confinement. What is the point of that? I mean, somebody wants out so badly they'll take being struck in the buttocks several times to get out? Man, it's awful. Just one more reason why I wouldn't send my kid to these government indoctrination centers. Mm. They're just terrible, everything about them. And I don't think that private schools are that much better. I went to one for 9 years. But it made me go looking on the spanking subject, and I found a story that really sort of addresses this. From Reuters, 8 former youth workers are being indicted on charges they routinely spanked young men in custody last year at a Boston residential facility to punish them, prosecutors said Wednesday. The indictments came after a year-long state police investigation into the Casa Isla Department of Youth Services facility located on an island in Boston Harbor. The program housed 14 to 19-year-old, they call them boys, where I come from, those sound like men to me, at least young men, who committed by the juvenile courts. Assistant district attorney whatever told the court the defendants spanked young men at the facility from April to August of 2014. The men worked at the facility, hired through, get this, Volunteers of America, would pull a young man's pants down and hit his bare buttocks with an orange department-issued sandal in a game they called Orange Chicken. Prosecutors said that at the arraignment on Wednesday, victims were targeted if they misbehaved or if they had been returned to the facility after being discharged. Maroney said the technique was often used on the eve of a child's release, as a warning not to return. Yeah, I was in prison for 8.5 years. I can tell you there was a little bit of hazing that would go on a person's last day sometimes. You know, we'd punch them in the legs. I don't know if you have been punched good and hard in your thigh, but it can crumple you to the ground if it's done well enough and if you're not prepared for it. But we also punched each other all the time anyway. So to some extent, you were prepared for it. You didn't want to send somebody home with a black eye. You know, everybody was rooting for him to have some luck with the ladies when he returned. But there was a certain amount of animosity. You would remind them not to come back and, you know, these kind of things. And just the opportunity to hit somebody, I think. So I might be biased on this one, but I think that it's unconscionable that an article is written and, you know, these people are brought up on charges for punching inmates, essentially. And I was at a youthful offender prison. We did have people from 14 to 19 at this prison. We had young men as young as 12, as a matter of fact, at this prison. So I have experience in places like this. And I think it's unconscionable that in public schools, and I believe it's still more than it's more than 10 states that still have corporal punishment on the books. And if please call me and make an argument that it is fine to hit kids, but not fine to hit convicts. And, you know, if we can look at, if we can look at why they stopped hitting convicts, then we should probably be able to apply that to why they shouldn't be applying corporal punishment in schools. Now, the school I went to had corporal punishment. I don't know about the government school. I never experienced it, but maybe they did, maybe they didn't. I don't know. Because I don't think that the punishment particularly mattered. For me, it was about getting caught. I would not have wanted to do it because I didn't want to get caught, and the punishment really wouldn't have made a difference. You know, getting spanked, probably in the case of this young girl of 2012, she'd rather get spanked than sitting in school suspension because at least it's over. Now, in this case, the mother was complaining that there were welts on her butt. I don't know what she exactly expected when your child gets struck on the bottom with some hard object, you're probably going to be some welts. So there's always people raising their voice in defense of spanking when I say that I don't spank my son. My son Jack is reasonably well behaved. He got himself in trouble this morning. But he's a, you know, probably as behaved as any, single or only child. And he But he just has never been spanked. We've never found the reason to do it. I understand. Believe me, in dealing with a kid that's sassing back and being irritating or whatever, I get it. I know what it's like to feel that feeling. I've just kind of made the commitment that I'm going to try a little social experiment here and see whether or not we can do it with other forms of discipline. And now I know, Johnson, you don't believe that negative discipline works at all, right?
Well, certainly not physical discipline, no.
What about timeouts and things like that?
I don't know. I mean, I have no idea. I have no intention of being a parent anytime soon, so, or ever.
At the very least, this is the most honest answer, because I mean, what, as a parent, I find there are many, many people who don't have children that are more than happy to give me advice on how to deal with kids.
I know what I don't like, you know, like what I don't like seeing, you know, having with kids and abusing kids. I mean, it's scientifically proven to make them dumber.
Well, abuse, I mean, certainly, yeah. But I don't
know,
that-
regular just slapping. Like, no. It doesn't have to be physical abuse. No. I know you want to argue that, but it's a slap. Repeated over time. Right. That type
over
of...
time. But this is the thing, is that many parents...
It doesn't have to be abuse, though. Corporal punishment causes loss of IQ, period.
Right.
It's not like physical... It's not like a physical abuse thing. The brain defends itself. And when the brain has to defend itself and creating that level of cognitive dissonance, my mommy and daddy hit me because they love me, that causes your brain to lose power. Period. It powers down to power up cognitive dissonance.
Then why doesn't it work in the same way on punishments like timeout and a variety of other things that are done, taking away of the Kindle?
Because
or,
they're not.
The iPad
it's not like physical pain. It's not. It's not tied into the pain receptors. I mean, there's like an explosion of pain that happens when you're getting slapped or hit or anything like that.
I'd rather take those smacks on the butt than sit an in-school suspension.
I would imagine. Here's the interesting thing. I would actually imagine if given the chance. If the kid was able to prepare and, you know, make the choice in advance, that would probably have some sort of an insulating effect. I would imagine that would be true. That if somebody's saying like, oh well, I'll take that as a punishment, and they're making a choice, and it's not that they're just getting slapped.
So kids in war experiences often have all kinds of negative ramifications in their personalities, and I think that's because of terror. And I think that's what happens with kids that are that get spankings as punishment, is that they can live sort of in terror.
Mm-hmm.
And this is not all kids that get spankings. I just believe it's the ones that they're administered to often. Many
right.
times when parents administer spankings, they don't know how often they administer it. Your thoughts, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live, or lrn.fm on Skype, 855-450-FREE.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you, or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
You know what rubs millions of people the wrong way? Their thighs.
Shaq talks Gold Bond Friction Defense.
Skin friction is quite an affliction. On your legs, arms, whether you're running a 5K or just running upstairs.
And Gold Bond Friction Defense is...
soothing.
Indeed. It's non-greasy, moisturizes, and helps like nobody's business.
Because your thighs rubbing together is nobody's business.
Gold Bond Friction Defense. Defense starts now.
Your thighs will thank you.
Oh boy.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, July 23rd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.82 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,099 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $279. Antiwar.com reports a suicide bomber detonated in a crowded marketplace in Afghanistan's northern Faryab province yesterday, killing at least 19 people and wounding 38 others. There's been no claim of responsibility thus far for the strike. The immediate suspicion was that it was a Taliban attack, as the Afghan government and Taliban forces have been fighting over control of the province, with both sides claiming some gains over the other in the past week. The Islamic State has also been active in some of northern Afghanistan as well. Provincial police say the attack targeted a group of soldiers guarding the market, but that the casualties also included a number of civilian bystanders. The fear is that the death toll will rise further because of the number of serious injuries. During this year's spring offensive, much of the Taliban's activity has been in the northern portion of the country, with efforts to secure territory that they did not even fully control before the 2001 U.S. invasion and occupation. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy. And for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports Glacier National Park's most popular roadway was shut down and homes and lodging areas were evacuated as firefighters continue their efforts to contain fast-moving wildfires that were inching closer to populated areas. A section of Going to the Sun Road in Glacier National Park remained closed Wednesday between the park's St. Mary entrance and the east side and avalanche area on the west side in response to a 1,000-acre fire. The park operated 72-unit Rising Sun Motor Inn and cabins in the nearby Rising Sun campground were evacuated. Chris Ross Miller, who was at the motel as firefighters were spraying down buildings, said, "It's smoky up here and nobody really knows how big the fire is." The fire was first reported around 3:45 p.m. Tuesday and quickly spread. Park rangers continued their search for backcountry hikers in the area. A temporary flight restriction was put into place over the area. Other wildfires as well spread quickly. Some were started by lightning strikes and others started by people.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports New York moved on Wednesday to raise the minimum wage for fast food workers to $15 an hour by the end of 2018 in New York City and by mid-2021 in the rest of the state. The New York Wage Board voted unanimously for the increase, which would cover some 180,000 workers statewide and affects fast food chains with 30 locations or more in the United States. The three-member board was formed at the behest of Governor Andrew Cuomo in May after the state legislature turned down his proposal for a minimum wage increase for most workers. Its decision does not need legislative approval, but requires approval by the state labor commissioner, which is expected. At a jubilant rally in New York City celebrating the vote, a beaming Cuomo said, "This is going to help hundreds of thousands of New Yorkers, but this is going to do something else, because when New York acts, the rest of the states follow." Last month, Los Angeles set its minimum wage to rise from $9 an hour to $15 per hour by 2020, affecting some 600,000 workers. Seattle and San Francisco have also increased minimum wage in recent years. The rise to $15 an hour marks a major step from New York's current minimum wage of $8.75 per hour. The increase would be phased in, taking effect by the end of 2018 in New York City and by July 2021 in the rest of the state. Business groups groups and other critics slammed the decision as discriminatory because it singled out one industry and legal challenges are expected. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The producers of Sesame Street have responded to the controversy over the recent New Yorker cover that showed Bert and Ernie as a gay couple celebrating the repeal of DOMA. Sesame Workshop released a statement today saying, quote, "We have never viewed Bert and Ernie as a gay couple, but as two friends who will do absolutely anything to get their rocks off. These pansexual perverts cannot be categorized in your narrow gay, straight, or bisexual paradigm. They're into some pretty sick shit." On their website, PBS released a long list of the duo's strange sexual fetishes, which range from shoving ice into their anuses so that they can shit cold water into women's mouths, to castrating stray dogs and then masturbating onto the animals' bleeding wounds. Although they're flattered that fans have turned the characters into gay icons, the producers explained that calling them gay would be inaccurate. Quote, "They will literally f*** anything that moves." The producers also added that Oscar the Grouch is neither male nor female, and that its trash can is designed to hide a lower body that is just a Lovecraftian monstrosity of hundreds of interlocking penises and vaginas.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call there, or you can use Skype. The username is lrn.fm. I probably should have told you earlier, but Ian, our sort of main host, he is off this evening. This is his night off. So we were talking about a situation where this, up in Boston, this juvenile home, I think is the best thing to describe it. Some of the people that work there were administering spankings, beatings of some sort, to inmates. And that got them indicted. I want to know why it is that it's an indictable offense for prison guards, essentially, you know, whatever, workers at youth homes. These kids are between, these young men are between the ages of 14 and 19. So I think that qualifies as a young man. I don't really, I mean, they kept on using the term child in the story, but, you know, if they can hit kids in government schools, if vice principals can do that there, then why in the world can't they hit inmates? Now, I'm not advocating for hitting inmates. I don't think that corporal punishment's particularly effective, but, you know, I think that there's some argument that it's ridiculous that kids can get hit and inmates can't. And there's another story that's kind of been brought up for me. It's in Maine. There's a situation where this lady who runs a breakfast place, she had a couple that was in there with her with their daughter, the two-year-old daughter. And it's a busy place. This is one of those sort of breakfast places where you wait to get seated. And people do because I guess it's that way.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, it's King Mark the First with you.
And Johnson.
And what was happening was that I guess this was one of those couples, right? Like they don't discipline the kid. That's the story, the way that I got the story. So the kid, according to reports, screamed for 40 minutes in the restaurant. The restaurant owner asked the couple to take the kid outside. They refused.
We're trying a new strategy. It's called unparenting.
We let the kid run around like a maniac and do whatever they want, and we just see how it goes. And I think that mostly it doesn't matter. Frankly, I think that is when people, you know, that the parenting strategies, by the time the kid hits 30, it just doesn't really make a difference. You know, whatever. They've recovered from whatever stupid crap you were doing, and whatever you were doing was stupid crap. So, you know, fine. You know, human beings are just messed up primates anyway. So I don't think that that's that big of a deal. It's just that you shouldn't subject other people to it. If you're going to try, say, an unparenting strategy, you should try an unrestaurant strategy too, because if your kid is going to go and wail, and a two-year-old is going to wail, and two-year-olds have lungs, if you you know, as a father of a kid who's been through, you know, twos, threes, fours, I think the wailing of an infant is cute. I love to hear it. I think it's hilarious. It's cute as it could be. Whereas, you know, those
kill me now.
3-year-olds, man, they can bellow.
Yeah.
They can make some noise. And ultimately, what the restaurateur owner did is she pointed her finger in her face and told her to shut her mouth. And the kid shut up.
Right.
It worked. Because the kids, you know, this loop, this feedback loop that she was getting where, you know, screaming is what I've got to do to get what I want, was broken. Whoa. And a lot of people seem to be sort of going after the restaurateur owner in this one. And people are taking sides, right? Some people are taking the sides of the parents. Like, I would never let anyone yell at my child. Well, to me, the child was being treated like an adult.
Right.
If I went into a restaurant and screamed at the top of my lungs for 40 seconds, not 40 minutes, I would think that I would have a reasonable expectation of being asked to leave, being yelled at. Somebody's got to get over the din that I'm creating, right? So they're going to have to raise their voice to talk to me. And you know, I'm already a bit of a loud individual. Usually at a restaurant, I know how to turn it down a notch or two. But, you know, this kid received the behavior that a responsible adult would have received in the same circumstance. Somebody yelled at her, and she got actually a great deal of leniency if she managed to go on for 40 minutes. And the parents were shocked and appalled at the behavior of this crazy woman. Now, I don't know what happened actually in that restaurant. I wasn't there. Right. So, you know, there are simply reports of what happened in the restaurant. So I'm going to go with, I think that there are definitely parents in the world that would raise their kid in a fashion that they wouldn't say anything to them about screaming in a restaurant. And I think there are definitely people that would react by yelling at the kid. So I'm going to go ahead and just, assume that I know what the circumstances were and realize that there's never been a true news report yet. And you think there was a true news report?
No, I'm agreeing. Okay.
Yeah. So that's what I kind of do here on Free Talk Live is I assume that there's so many crazy things happen in the world that I can just kind of come up with a scenario and then talk about it. And I guess I want to know, is it acceptable to talk to other people's children? Because sometimes I just go ahead and when I talk to young people, children, I talk to them like an adult. When young men come to my house to play with my son, Jack, I have the expectation they're going to shake my hand, look me in the eye, and talk to me. Because I expect them to comport themselves in that fashion. And I now, one of his little friends, he comes over to me, looks me in the eye, and shakes my hand when he arrives and says, you know, hello. I don't expect them to call me Mr. Edgington or, you know, whatever they're going to call me. I don't expect that. I just expect them to, you know, like comport yourself like an adult in these fashions. And they're going to how else are they going to grow up to be them? And if somebody and I have yelled at other people's, hey, stop that. You know, other people's kids doing things at my house, you know, raise my voice, catch their attention and what they're doing.
I don't know. I don't think that I would be yelling at somebody else's kid unless they were on my property.
Uh-huh. Well, in this case, the restaurateur, that's exactly what happened.
And I think that if I were the parents of that child and I didn't want somebody else yelling at my kid, I just wouldn't go back to that restaurant.
Well, they clearly won't go back to that restaurant, but they're taking it further. This story has gone nationwide, and it's kind of interesting how people are sort of reacting to it. I feel like here it says the main diner owner says she's not sorry for yelling at the 21-month-old child for crying at her restaurant because it got the girl to be quiet. And it was effective. But a lot of people, there's a backlash on social media. This is one of these news stories that's sort of created by Facebook.
Right.
It says here that the girl had been crying for 40 minutes by the time she slammed her hands on the counter and told the girl to be quiet. Now, this is what the restaurateur owner is saying, and I don't expect anyone to be entirely honest. I just I don't think that humans are honest creatures.
Right.
But if a kid had been yelling for 10 minutes, I don't think there's anything wrong with catching their attention with some noise. Because what this is basically is comes down to sort of, well, that looks it looks bad. It looks
I'm just
bad.
Imagining like, what, you know, how I would, if I were in that situation, it'd just be like a clap. Hey, shut it down.
You know, some people are suggesting and that, you know, she could have, you know, caught the attention, like clapped her hands and started singing or something in front of the kid, you know, tried to. Well, these things, I'll tell you what, the most effective parenting techniques are redirections.
Sure.
They really, really work. If you can, if she could have used her sort of power as a stranger to redirect this child, I think that would have been optimal. But I'm not going to fault her. Anybody who's been subjected to a kid that's been yelling for 40 minutes has lost their mind to some extent. And you got to do what you can to regain your sanity.
This wouldn't be a story if she had just pulled a coin out from behind the kid's ear.
What do you think? 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Attention, business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Identity theft is real. So real, it could be making you its next victim right now. At the gas pump, bank, or store where you shop with your credit card, bad guys with RFID scanners can peer into your wallet or purse from a short distance away, stealing information from your RFID-enabled credit or debit cards, passports, room keys, and ID cards without you even knowing it. Stop the bad guys now with an RFID-blocking wallet from ID Stronghold. ID Stronghold founded the entire RFID blocking industry over 10 years ago. Their stylish sleeves, clutch purses, and wallets are shielded throughout. The best you can buy at great pricing, as low as $14.99. Don't wait until your wallet needs replacing. Protect your identity now. Click IDStronghold.com or call 1-800-610-2770. That's 1-800-610-2770. ID Stronghold, the original RFID wallet company.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online poker site?
Do you have a poker sound effect? Because we have a new advertiser, swcpoker.eu.
Brought to you by the same guys that did Seals with Clubs.
Now they're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. The Krill leaderboard is active now. It's Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, swcpoker.eu.
Get on over to swcpoker.eu and start playing now.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. King Mark the First with you.
And Johnson.
You know, the internet, you're tootling around on the internet. You do the things you do on the internet. It feels safe. It isn't safe. There are, for instance, your internet service provider, they're saving all of your history. They'll turn it over to any government agency that asks for it. Likely anybody who, any hackers that manage to get it from them. Criminals are, in fact, sniffing your Wi-Fi packets, trying to find out banking information. Governments and corporations are limiting what you can see on the internet, and the NSA is sweeping up all your data. ProXPN can solve all of that. You just download an app for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux, whatever. They make it easy for you. You connect to the internet after you've got the app, and you're protected from all of that. No more prying, no more spying. One account works for all your devices. You don't have to have separate accounts for each device. ProXPN.com/FTL. You go there, you get 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy an annual account with our code. It's FTL50. That's like $5 a month. So that's for the lifetime of the account, with no matter how long you keep it. You get this is the premium account, and you get unlimited bandwidth, servers all around the world that you can access. That means that you can be in Oklahoma, and it looks like you're surfing from Singapore. It's amazing. Also, you get you can privately torrent, get past regionally blocked websites, and they don't keep records of your online habits at all. You just you get all that with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. ProXPN.com/FTL, promo code FTL50. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless.
So, Mark, can I have a tangent? One more tangential thing.
You and your tangents.
I like to tangent. You know, Ian's not around, so someone here has to entertain these stoner questions.
Okay.
So, you are a well-known drinker of caffeine-free beverages.
Yeah, I can't have caffeine.
So, I guess my hypothetical question, this goes out to the audience. Why are always caffeine-free sodas represented by the color gold?
I don't know.
You know, as a designer, I notice these things, and it's just like, why? What's the purpose? Is it just to make it seem more high-end? Oh, caffeine-free. It's gold.
I don't know. I think it's just happened. You know, they had to distinguish. Somebody had to distinguish their caffeine-free beverage from their caffeinated beverage, and they decided to go with gold. And
like, it doesn't matter what other colors are in the package. If it's caffeine-free, there's going to be some gold in there.
Not always. Mug root beer, for instance, doesn't really have gold. And almost all root beers, except for Barks. Barks has bite. Somebody decided to add caffeine to root beer making.
I am an anti-root beer person. The only way root beer is ever acceptable is if it's in a float.
Well, root beer is an old beverage. I mean, yeah. It's basically a sarsaparilla, right?
Yeah.
And
sarsaparilla.
This is what, you know, our great grandfathers drank when they got a treat.
I like to sit on the porch, shoot my shotgun, and drink me a sarsaparilla.
Because soda is nothing but liquid candy. And this was, you know, it was a big treat to get something like that. It wasn't something that you had at every meal or something. I mean, you're talking about, I had one.
What an awful treat. I guess that's a great way to make it not one anymore, is just make it the only one. The only one you can get is a Dr. Pepper. Or not a Dr. Pepper. I'm sorry. I got that on my screen. But a root beer. I like Dr. Pepper. Root beer is just nasty. Never been a huge fan of that.
Well,
Know that I've ever had a real sarsaparilla, though. I don't know what the difference is between root beer and sarsaparilla.
I don't know. When we were talking about the sort of old-timey drinks, I'm much more of a ginger brew kind of guy.
Yeah, ginger beer is good. And you know, just regular ginger ale.
So I want to get back to the story here of this.
The question still stands, though, if anybody knows the answer. Stoners, put your minds to it.
This is from a, well, it was a diner in Portland, Maine, and the basically there was a kid who was crying her head off for 40 minutes, the report is that the restaurateur slaps her hands down. This is after 40 minutes, slaps her hands down on the counter and says, points at the little girl and says, "That needs to stop," and apparently it did. The girl's mother, Tara Carson, wrote on Facebook that anyone with young children should understand that crying is normal after waiting such a long time for food.
Oh, that's what's really going on. What an awful, gross, disgusting parent. That's what's really going on.
I turned to my daughter and I was like, "Listen, this is how I'm raising you not to be as an adult."
Yeah. Like, she's using her kid. What a gross person. Ugh.
You will never do this when you get older, Carson said. I felt helpless as the mom, that, you know, I couldn't do anything to help her because I can't explain why there are crazy people in the world that behave like that. I think that anybody who is had to endure a kid yelling for 40 minutes is going to be crazy. Like, it makes you crazy. Look, I mean, when you're talking about kids on airplanes where their ears are popping. Yeah, you know, sometimes they're better than others. When you go on an airplane, you know you're dealing with everybody going there. When you're going to a restaurant, you...
Kid's lucky then she didn't get a frying pan winged at her.
Well, that wouldn't have solved anything. But the parents should have taken the kid outside.
Would have been quiet pretty quick.
Right? I mean, that would be the thing to do is you're not going to... Is the parent intending to use the kid's yelling to drive patrons out of the restaurant so they can get a seat? I mean, I don't know.
Yeah.
Is it some kind of blackmail? I don't know the answer to that. But I don't think this restaurateur did anything particularly crazy. You know, she was driven
restaurateur,
to her wits' end.
Had I been the restaurateur, you know, about 10 minutes into that yelling, I would have gone over there probably and said, "You need to take your child outside or you need to leave."
She did. She actually told the parents that they needed to leave, and they refused.
Oh, I'd have been like, "Oh, well, then I'm calling the police."
That's really the option here, yeah. is that you know, she handled it without the police, and you know, there you go. So,
or in a libertarian society, you'd get on one of your apps that call your friends, your armed friends, over to remove them. Yeah. Right? I mean, how's that? That's how that works.
Is that Peacekeeper?
Sure.
I don't think or Peacekeeper has, yeah. has a call for you know,
security.
Just rowdy kids.
It's a security situation, right? I mean, I'm saying in a true libertarian society, if there were no police.
Yeah.
Obviously, in this case, the way the world works now, in that instance, who you're going to call? You need somebody trespassed off your property who's trespassing because you've asked them to leave at that point. The only service that you can call in the world we live in is the police.
Sure.
But I'm saying if there were no police, if there were no government security thing, you had competing security services or whatnot in a society, maybe you would just get on your app or whatever and have your friends come remove somebody in a way that was legal.
Well, yeah, likely that would be the acceptable. And likely security, you know, generally when people see that you're serious about them leaving, they leave. They might throw a few barbs on their way out, but they're going to leave.
Right.
And, you know, make a kerfuffle. And mostly people just kind of look at that and go, whatever. And
I mean, I've actually seen a screaming child be kicked out of a restaurant. You know what happened? Everyone in the restaurant clapped.
Yeah.
Get out. Take your stupid kid and leave. If you can't keep your kid quiet and be a decent parent and actually do something, then you need to go because you're a bad person that's interfering with everyone else's lives because of your mistake.
It's not the kid's fault. The kid hasn't.
No, it's not the kid's fault. It's the parents' fault.
855-450-3733. Your thoughts? You know, maybe we're completely wrong on this one. 855-450-3733, Free Talk Live, or lrn.fm on Skype.
We love that you're passionate about GCN. And whether you're a listener, a business owner, or a radio industry professional, we've redesigned the new GCN newsletter to keep you in the know. Get updates on your favorite GCN shows and hosts. Go to GCNlive.com and click on the banner in the upper left corner. Just for signing up, you're automatically entered for monthly giveaways. Start receiving your newsletter today. The future of talk radio. GCN.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's 855-450-FREE. King Mark the First with you.
And Johnson.
And you can call in on any old topic. We've been kind of talking about, we brushed over spanking and this situation in Maine where this restaurateur yells at a 2-year-old and, you know, people's thoughts on that. I guess this is sort of a, you know, important story on social media and maybe it's important to you. I don't know. But it made me, Johnson, you had previously said in one of the previous segments that essentially that spanking kids give us some lower IQs.
That's what science...
Yep. There's studies out there that suggest this. But so I have some questions because I do not believe this is a sort of overall thing. Yes, I do think kids that are terrorized and abused have lower IQs. Absolutely. Then again, people who are likely to terrorize and abuse their kids might have lower IQs anyway. We'll see. So anyway, my question is this. Is it one spanking that results in a lower IQ? Or is it one spanking per year? What's the threshold? Because when I wrestle with my son, this is sort of an ongoing joke in our house, is that when I wrestle with my son, sometimes I pat his bottom while we're wrestling just because it's, funny to do. I'll say, I'm taking IQ points. And, his mother, when they're sort of cuddling or being affectionate, sometimes she'll pat his bottom and he'll ask her, can you take some IQ points? Because, he wants his bottom patted.
So the number of times is none, once, twice, or three plus times.
Per what?
Per ever.
Week?
No.
Ever.
Yeah. Change in cognitive ability score. It's much, much more drastic if they're aged 2 to 4. And the cognitive ability score starts at none, obviously, like around a 6. I guess that's, there's probably, they're talking about a change in IQ points of 6 IQ points total. One time it drops from around 6 to 3. This is if they're 2 to 4. It drops from 3 to 1 if they're spanked twice, and it drops, down.
So is this instantly
to 0? Yeah, pretty much.
Well, I wouldn't say that. I would say that anybody who's in a circumstance where they're so upset that they're going to get spanked that they're not thinking anyway. So I don't know what you're talking. I guess I know you're on the fly here trying to come up with numbers, but
it's a very old study. But I
who spanks kids twice? Like I can see a parent that spanked a kid once and said, "You know what? Are you talking about swats per session?" This is what I don't
just
understand.
Spanked. I mean, some parents don't spank their kids very often.
Sure.
That's it's not a regular occurrence for a lot of parents.
Well, it seems funny to segment them this way. The one spanking, two spankings, and then 3 or more spankings ever?
That's what it looks like. I mean, I could be totally wrong.
Okay.
But I sent the study.
IM'd me here, the study. Yeah.
Yep. So you can see, and maybe we can get some clarity here. Let's see, 2 to 4, looking spanked.
Yeah, but so let me ask you this. Do you think it's the pain in the bottom that causes them? Because my son's experienced pain. He hasn't experienced spanking. It's not pain.
You got a good point there. Is it the pain or is it the fear?
Because my son, when I raise my voice, like his ears perk up, like it, the change in tone will catch his attention.
Sure.
So I'm sort of striking him with my voice.
Right.
I think it's the pain, as a parent. You've got to use something.
I think it's the pain that sort of elevates there's a fear response, and I think the pain elevates a fear response, and I think that fear response is probably, there's cognitive, there's a cost, right? There's a level of thinking, about. It's like, it's stress, essentially, is what it comes down to. I think it's a stress level.
He's been hurt, too.
Sure.
So he's been hurt. He's, he's been all these things that happen during
spanking. Yeah, but look at people who get hurt a lot, too. People, especially at a younger age.
Now we're talking about a lot again. See, this is the thing that... okay,
at a younger age.
I've looked at these studies, and, I find it interesting, right? Parents don't seem to know how often they employ spanking. Parents that say... I may spank 3 times a week, spank like 15 times a week. Those are the kind of numbers. They just don't report. It's like self-reporting your age or something. People just don't, they aren't honest with themselves about what occurs. So I can see that. I can honestly say we have never spanked, but can I say that I have never been physical with my son? Absolutely not. I've done that. If, for instance, he didn't want to get in the car or something like that, I've picked him up and put his little butt in the seat and strapped him in. And, that wouldn't look good. And by a libertarian definition, it's an initiation of force. But you know, sometimes you gotta go. And the kid isn't ready to go. They don't work on the same, you know, time frames. So is initiating force against my child like I did? How many IQ points did I cost him there? I don't understand how the pain.
Okay, well, here. Okay. So it says here, I'm going to skip to two paragraphs. How often parents spanked made a difference. The more spanking, the slower the development of the child's mental ability. But even in small amounts of spanking made a difference, Strauss says in the study. Now, let's go to the part about the reasoning. Strauss and colleagues in 32 nations on data and corporal punishment experienced by 17,404 university students when they were children. According to Strauss, there are two explanations for the relation of corporal punishment to lower IQ. First, corporal punishment is extremely stressful and can become a chronic stressor for young children, who typically experience corporal punishment three or more times a week. For many, it continues for years. The research found that the stress of corporal punishment shows up as an increase in post-traumatic stress symptoms, such as being fearful that terrible things are about to happen and being easily startled.
This is my contention.
These symptoms are associated with lower IQ.
This is the point that I've been trying to make all along, is that it's not spanking that causes kids to have lower IQ. It's ongoing terror. And so... Right. I don't think that employing spanking, this is talking about once, by the way.
And that's why I sort of agree with it. If they're making the choice to, you know, get that punishment or whatever, be spanked, it's not really like a terror. And I feel like that would be kind of inoculate them against the stress, the traumatic stress of like, you know, like being at war, you know, like bombs are going off, things are surprising you, like, you know, like. But if you're making a choice, like, I'm going to experience an explosion now, you know, like, it's not the same kind of thing.
I wouldn't employ spanking. If I were to employ spanking, and I have not taken it off the table with my son, I've just never had a need to do it. I would only employ it if the child's behavior became, you know, self-destructive to the point that we needed to, you know, something needed to happen to really change that behavior, or... you know, destructive of another kid. So if, for instance, you know, the kid kept wanting to go out in the street, you know, at that point, I would be willing to try spanking to see if that was going to happen. I know lots of people really hate this example, but the fact is kids go out in streets and it is the most terrifying thing in the world that a parent has to deal with. So I'd be willing to at that point. Now he's 7 years old. You can communicate with him and, you know, we haven't had to do that. But I would think to... You know, if one is administering a spanking more than once a year, that you would be abusing the punishment. That would be my contention.
Yeah. Apparently, there's a book on the subject entitled "Beating the Devil Out of Them: Corporal Punishment in American Families and Its Effects on Children."
Well, there's I know that, you know, many people are trying to get it removed entirely. And, you know, this kind of comes back to every parent believes.
Well, I think it absolutely should be removed from government schools.
Well, absolutely. I would agree with you. But many parents, most parents, I think, really think that most other parents are unqualified to raise kids. This is just sort of this innate superiority that people feel about themselves. And
teachers
their
are triply unqualified, in my opinion.
So I don't think that most parents are qualified to administer spankings. The problem is that the government isn't qualified to decide how you raise your kids either. And I'm probably not either. That's the difficulty. What do you think? 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live. The username is lrn.fm on Skype. 855-450-FREE.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
RFlags.com just found out that 49-year-old Anthony Hervey, a black man in Mississippi, he was chased down in his car and killed, apparently for his support of the Confederate flag. This will not stand. RFlags.com now offering 10% of every sale to go to the Hervey family to help them in their time of need. You want to help this family? Go to RFlags.com. We'll donate 10% of every sale. RFlags.com. That's RFlags.com.
Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keen, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Daryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallo Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Keenvention.info.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. This live edition of Free Talk Live, it's Mark.
And Johnson.
So we were talking about spanking in the last segment. Usually, you know, it's an issue that I think that our audience generally does not agree with us upon. And, you know, I've managed to raise a kid up to the age 7 without spanking him.
Hey, this is one of those possible. This is one of those topics that's like race. You don't have a kid, you can't possibly understand or talk about this.
Oh, I feel that way about people who give me parenting advice all the time. I really do. It's like, really? You're going to talk to me about raising kids? I mean, I think it's the vibrance of youth and their ideas, but at that point it becomes an issue of sort of phraseology. Look, at least understand that we that do have kids are dealing with an entirely different world from you that are imagining what it might be like to have kids. You know, it's day in, it's day out, and, you know, you got to have your own life. You can't just be the parent of your kid constantly, you know, like every time. They are attention-sucking machines,
and they want you to pay attention to them constantly. Well, you can't. There's a household to run, there's jobs to have, and all these other things. So, you know, cats in the cradle or whatever, somebody's got to make the money. 855-450-FREE. I don't know. It's you know, I just saw the Ant-Man movie this weekend, by the way, and in it the daughter plays a strong role. The dad, you know, is in jail, gets out of jail, and he wants to be part of the daughter's life. And it's interesting how important these roles are. You know, I mean, you know, your children are the most important thing in the world to you, but it, you know, when they're there, it can be really difficult to sort of get things done. So it's, you know, you have this person who is both the most important thing in the world to you and the biggest annoyance you deal with. So, and they don't talk about necessarily interesting things all the time. Like Jack wants to talk about Legos constantly. Legos, Legos, Legos. And when we're not talking about Legos, he wants to talk about Magic School
Bus. Does he do Minecraft?
Yeah, he does Minecraft too. You know, all the different things that he, you know, and of course his on his little Kindle thing, he gets to play Minecraft. And he only gets to do that. We do an hour in, I think it's an hour in the morning that he gets to play on the Kindle. I'm not entirely sure. I'm not the one who rations this stuff off. But by the way, Ant-Man, if you get an opportunity to see it, I think it was worth seeing in the theaters.
I want to see Ant-Man. I want to see Terminator Genesis. I still haven't seen that one, which is crazy. I love the Terminator movies. I recently just watched a movie that blew my mind. Ex Machina.
Yeah, I've heard that it's... Yeah, I know it's out there. I didn't pay any money to see it. Do you think I should?
Sure.
Okay.
I didn't pay any money to see it either when I watched it at home. Won't say what that means.
Pro XPN, folks.
Pro XPN.
You can torrent privately.
And I won't say that I didn't use Pro XPN and was sent to cease and desist. Yeah. Use your Pro XPN, folks. This movie, I mean, what's amazing about this movie is super intellectual about artificial intelligence, essentially. And one of the things that I came away from this movie thinking is that, you know, the Turing test, right? You know what the Turing test is.
The Turing test is some kind of test that allows you to know, let us know whether computers have become self-aware.
It's a psychological test that essentially, if you're talking to a machine and you can't tell it's a machine, that machine has passed the Turing test.
Okay.
And it's not just anybody.
It's a series of questions?
It's not just anybody that can, you know, issue the Turing test, because there are some stupid people that would not be able to tell a chatbot now from a human being. You know, like it has to be a trained psychologist, you know, that asks some pointed questions and determines whether or not this android or machine is actually a human being.
Can you explain to me chatbots? Now, I've been on, I used to have Pigeon, which would put together sort of my, I think
it's
my...
a conversational algorithm that records responses over time to thousands and thousands of different questions. It's not AI. A chatbot is just going through scripted responses to certain questions, and that's where they always sound ridiculous.
I know what they are, but they would always, they'd be these, they'd have silly names like, you know, Big Hooters 69, right? And, you know, this female woman on the internet would want to talk to me, and I'd be like, these are all very strange things to be talked about. I wouldn't
some of these might not have been chatbots. They might have just been foreigners trying to get people to come to your, you know, to go to a porn site.
Now, usually I'd say just silly, stupid things,
right,
and then they'd continue talking. Like, I'd just say dumb things to them to see what they'd say. But what is the purpose of these chatbots? What are they trying to get you to do?
The real useful ones were helpful in creating conversational search engines. So like the really useful ones, you just say a question to, and it would respond with useful.
Yes, but why did they come find me on Instant Messenger?
Well, that's just because somebody was using a chatbot program to spam you.
But why? Why do they use up the computer power to bother me? I guess
because some people are so stupid that they don't know the difference, and they go, oh, okay, I'll go to this website. You sound like a real party girl.
Oh, I see. There's a website. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Like they're trying to get you to go to one of these dating websites or you know, some place to look at naked women or something like that, as though you can't see that anywhere on the internet.
Right, exactly.
You know.
Hey, man, the dumb people that don't know where to go. But so this movie, what I came away from this movie is thinking, and it is deep, you know, like coming away from this is like, you know, the Turing test, if you think about it, testing, if you came across an AI that's actually intelligent and actually has consciousness and actually is a sentient being, right? Putting that sentient being through a psychological test to determine whether or not they're sentient. Imagine if I were testing whether or not you're sentient.
Yeah, I don't know.
That's extremely dehumanizing. Like, and obviously, we're not talking about a human, but if you're talking about a sentient being and basically saying, I don't know whether or not you're actually a thinking being or not, and putting them through, like, you kind of realize, like, wow, that's kind of horrifying, that test. It's, like, extremely, like, this is the first, this is what we want to do to the first sentient machine is we're going to put them through this. Like, okay, well, that seems like a really bad idea. It's just really interesting that, I mean, that the movie went there, and I just found myself really impressed by
if a machine indignation is something that people develop over time. So if a machine is the first sentient machine, it's going to know that it's the first sentient machine, and it's going to understand that people tend to sort of investigate things that are new and different to them. If I ended up for whatever reason in, you know, some remote area of the world where, you know, this group of people had never seen a white person before, I would expect them to want to touch my skin, to want to feel my hair, to investigate things about me, because they didn't know things, you know, they didn't know that. And that isn't, I wouldn't be put off or annoyed or anything like that. Now, if I lived there for 20 years amongst them and it just kept happening, the same people over and over again, it's like, hey, you know, like maybe this is getting a little weird, okay? but I mean, people investigate new things. I think for the premise of a movie that a robot or, you know, AI that gets indignant might be an interesting story to tell, but I don't think that I don't think it's unusual for people want to investigate and find out, you know, what is this different thing?
Yeah.
So what happened in this ex machina thing that was so interesting about it that you liked so much?
Well, that's what I'm saying is that the fact that I came away from the movie thinking, you know, hey, this Turing test is maybe not the best idea. It's sort of, that was a really new way for me to think about it. You know, like up until now, it's sort of this cold way of thinking like, hey, yeah, we need to come up with a way to determine whether or not you know, an artificial intelligence is truly intelligent. You think about it in a sort of an analytical way, but then when you humanize that and you realize like, hey, you're talking about a conscious being and testing that conscious being to determine whether or not they're a conscious being and how inhuman is that? It's really puts a new face on thinking about AI and
the robot
dawn of
get
AI.
Upset?
Oh yeah.
The robot got upset, and of course, it's smarter than we are and faster than we are, so it took over the world or something.
Nah, I won't go as far to say that, and I don't want to reveal exactly what happened because, you know, it's extremely more nuanced than that.
I, for one,
like huge levels of nuance beyond that are really interesting.
Our new robot overlords.
Yeah,
I mean, can they really do any worse?
Yeah,
I mean, look, Hillary Clinton's running against Jeb Bush. Can you make an argument to me that robots would be worse rulers?
I think, Mark, that you would really dig this movie because you would dig the character in this movie that is a billionaire.
I think you would dig this guy. The idea of being a billionaire, and your king. check us out in the meantime on Facebook. It's facebook.freetalklive.com. It's been Mark with you.
And Johnson.
Free Talk Live.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship
and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Flaming Freedom is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, July 23rd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.82 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,099 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $279. Antiwar.com reports a suicide bomber detonated in a crowded marketplace in Afghanistan's northern Faryab province yesterday, killing at least 19 people and wounding 38 others. There's been no claim of responsibility thus far for the strike. The immediate suspicion was that it was a Taliban attack, as the Afghan government and Taliban forces have been fighting over control of the province, with both sides claiming some gains over the other in the past week. The Islamic State has also been active in some of northern Afghanistan as well. Provincial police say the attack targeted a group of soldiers guarding the market, but that the casualties also included a number of civilian bystanders. The fear is that the death toll will rise further because of the number of serious injuries. During this year's spring offensive, much of the Taliban's activity has been in the northern portion of the country, with efforts to secure territory that they did not even fully control before the 2001 U.S. invasion and occupation. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports Glacier National Park's most popular roadway was shut down and homes and lodging areas were evacuated as firefighters continue their efforts to contain fast-moving wildfires that were inching closer to populated areas. A section of Going to the Sun Road in Glacier National Park remained closed Wednesday between the park's St. Mary entrance and the east side and avalanche area on the west side in response to a 1,000-acre fire. The park operated 72-unit Rising Sun Motor Inn and cabins in the nearby Rising Sun campground were evacuated. Chris Ross Miller, who was at the motel as firefighters were spraying down buildings, said, "It's smoky up here and nobody really knows how big the fire is." The fire was first reported around 3:45 p.m. Tuesday and quickly spread. Park rangers continued their search for backcountry hikers in the area. A temporary flight restriction was put into place over the area. Other wildfires as well spread quickly. Some were started by lightning strikes and others started by people.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports New York moved on Wednesday to raise the minimum wage for fast food workers to $15 an hour by the end of 2018 in New York City and by mid-2021 in the rest of the state. The New York Wage Board voted unanimously for the increase, which would cover some 180,000 workers statewide and affects fast food chains with 30 locations or more in the United States. The three-member board was formed at the behest of Governor Andrew Cuomo in May after the state legislature turned down his proposal for a minimum wage increase for most workers. Its decision does not need legislative approval, but requires approval by the state labor commissioner, which is expected. At a jubilant rally in New York City celebrating the vote, a beaming Cuomo said, "This is going to help hundreds of thousands of New Yorkers, but this is going to do something else, because when New York acts, the rest of the states follow." Last month, Los Angeles set its minimum wage to rise from $9 an hour to $15 per hour by 2020, affecting some 600,000 workers. Seattle and San Francisco have also increased minimum wage in recent years. The rise to $15 an hour marks a major step from New York's current minimum wage of $8.75 per hour. The increase would be phased in, taking effect by the end of 2018 in New York City and by July 2021 in the rest of the state. Business groups and other critics slammed the decision as discriminatory because it singled out one industry, and legal challenges are expected. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Like many young inner-city students, Chicago-area high school sophomore Brandy Perkins struggles every day to motivate her teachers. The frustrated 16-year-old talked to Onion reporters this morning to discuss the challenges she faces in reaching out to her underperforming educators.
Connecting with the teachers gets harder and harder every year. We all come in every morning eager to learn, but most of the teachers just seem completely uninterested in education. One of my teachers, Ms. Manley, has been particularly hard to work with. She was quiet at first, but she showed some potential. I thought maybe she just needed a little time to come out of her shell, but as the weeks went by, she just sat there listlessly at her desk, never talking or participating. It just makes you feel so helpless.
For more on this story, check this week's Onion Review.
This is the Onion News Network.